What's going on, guys? Today we're going to be telling you how you guys can make a lot of bells fishing in Animal Crossing. So basically, if you're not a time traveler, later in the video, I'm going to be covering every single fish that you can get and how much they are. Well, for the more expensive fish, we're not going to go over like the cheaper fish because that doesn't matter. We don't need to go over the fish that aren't going to get you any bells. We're talking about the fish that are actually going to earn you a lot of bells in Animal Crossing. But for the time travelers, you guys can go into any time of the year you want and target the expensive fish that you would like to catch, or any fish that you need for your museum or encyclopedia or whatever. But I'm going to be going over later the fish that, if you're not time traveling, the ones that are right now available in June. And this is going to be the Northern Hemisphere, not the Southern Hemisphere, just because most of the people watching this video have the Northern Hemisphere in their island, and it just makes it so much easier to just go over one, because it can get very confusing if we say both. But anyway, let's go over some generic like fishing tips so you guys can actually get these fish a little bit easier. First thing we're going to want to talk about is fish bait. Now, I'm sure you guys have heard of fish bait, but some of you guys may not know actually how to get it, or maybe some people don't even know what it is. Basically, fish bait is going to allow you to throw this item, this disposable item. You can only use it once for each fish bait you have. You throw it in the water, in any body of water, whether it's a pond, a lake, or the ocean for Animal Crossing, and you're actually able to draw a fish to that one spot. Every fish bait you have, you will draw only one fish, but it can be any size. Now, we're also going to go over the sizes of fish right after this, but the fish bait, it can be made from the manila clams. Now, to get manila clams, if you don't know, you need to dig the little spots around on the beaches of your island. Now, these little spots are going to be the ones that you see the little circles of water coming out of the beach in the sand or whatever. And basically, you're going to dig in those spots and you'll actually get a manila clam. So you can keep doing that for a while, run around your beaches and look for these manila clam locations. Once you dig them up, you're going to go to any DIY bench, workbench, whatever, and you're going to actually craft fish bait. The fish bait costs one manila clam, so for everyone you dig up, you can get one fish bait. And for each fish bait, you're able to trade that in for a fish pretty much, as long as you have your fishing rod. I do recommend getting one of the fishing rods that are a little bit better, not the flimsy ones, because whether you buy them or not, or you craft them yourselves, the flimsy ones are going to break every 10 fish, and if you're catching a lot of fish, it's a lot easier, especially if you have the better fishing rod, but it's a lot easier to make bells, even though you can get them for free for the regular flimsy ones, as tree branches are unlimited and they are free and easy to get. But it's still better if you get the regular ones because they will last you much longer. So anyway, guys, another tip is going to be running around your beaches, scaring away the fish that you do not want. So if you're targeting certain fish sizes, which we're just going to go over in just a second, then you can scare away the ones you don't want based off of the size of the fish. So when we go over the fish sizes and you're looking for certain fish that have certain prices, you're able to know which fish that you actually want to catch and then actually scare away the ones you don't, because there's only so many fish that can spawn at one time, meaning that you can scare away the fish that have spawned that aren't worth much, but you can keep and try to catch the fish that are worth more. Now, the fish bait can give you in any random size of fish. Now, sizes of fish, right? You can the size of the shadow is determined when you look in the water. You can see how big the fish is. Now, that size of the shadow can be what they call size 1 through size 6. The size 6 being the largest shadow, and size 1 being the smallest shadow, the very smallest shadow that you can see in the water. Now, most of the expensive fish are going to be bigger fish in terms of shadow size, but there are a couple fish that are smaller that are still worth a good amount. We will go over that in just a second. But one more thing you guys are going to have to keep in mind is the time of the day. Now, the time of the day varies for what fish you can catch. If you fish in the morning, then you may only be able to see certain fish because the spawns of the fish change throughout the day, and they're only there in certain hours. So, and depends on the season as well. So that's just what you guys are going to keep in mind. And I'm going to tell you all of the expensive fish in Animal Crossing for June, the month of June. So if you time travel, you guys are definitely going to want to check out June, because at least looking at all of these, the sharks are in June and they're very expensive. We'll go over them in just a minute. So this list is going to cover all fish over 5,000 bells that you can catch in this month. So we're going to start. There's not really any particular order. We're just going to rattle them off. There are a couple pond ones on here. There's some river ones and some ocean ones. They're not going to be in any specific order, but we're just going to tell you, I'm just going to read them, and you're going to have to pay attention and write down any of the ones that you actually want to catch, if they're specific ones that you're going after. But if not, then maybe just go for the sharks, which we will explain at the end. So basically, from 9 a.m. to 4 p.m., you can catch the giant snakehead. It's a size 4 shadow, and it's in a pond. It goes for 5,500 bells. So for every fish that we're going to talk about, we're going to say the time of the day, what fish it is, the size of it, the price, and where you can catch it. So five important things, so make sure to pay attention. The snapping turtle, which can be caught in the river from 9 p.m. to 4 a.m., sells for 5,000 bells, and it has a shadow size of 4. The arowana is found in the river and is a size 4 shadow. It sells for 5,000 bells, and it can only be found from 10,000 bells, and it's found from 4 p.m. to 9 a.m., not 5,000. That was the snapping turtle. Now, for 15,000 bells, you can get the Dorado. It sells for 15,000 bells. It's a size 5 shadow, and you can find them in the river from 4 a.m. to 9 p.m. The gar, which can be found in the pond, sells for 6,000 bells. That's a size 5 fish, or size 5 shadow, from 4 p.m. to 9 a.m. The Baird knife jaw is an ocean fish. It's 5,000 bells, and you can find it all day, and it's a size 3 fish. The arapaima is a fish you can find in the river. It's a size 6 shadow from 4 p.m. to 9 a.m., and it sells for 10,000 bells. Now, I'm going to mention this fish, even though it's technically not 5,000 bells. It's only 4,000 bells, but it's a very rare fish in terms of actually trying to find them. The saddled bichir is a size 4 fish that you can find from 9 p.m. to 4 a.m. during the month of June. That is a very difficult to find fish, even though it is not an expensive one. Now, we're going to continue and go with the mahi-mahi. Now, the mahi-mahi is a special fish in terms of it's not just the ocean, and it's not just the ponds or the rivers. There's another thing you got to watch out for. You can only catch this fish on the pier. So make sure that you guys go to that little dock, that little pier on your ocean, and you go cast your line out there, whether you use fish bait to draw in fish and try to get this. It's a size 6, by the way, or size 5, sorry. It's a size 5, so you gotta look for a big shadow there. You can keep scaring fish on your ocean until you find one there, or you can throw fish bait, which is what I recommend. It can be caught all day. So that is the one benefit, is you can find it all times during the day. So if you're trying to catch other fish, like sharks or something, then you can come back whenever and look at the pier at that time of the day. Also, now we can go talk about the sharks. The saw shark, which is caught in the ocean, all the sharks are from the ocean, is a 12K fish, size 6, all the sharks are size 6, and they have a fin. The fin is important. That's how you distinguish easily between all the other fish. The problem is there's also sucker fish, which have a fin, but they are not size 6. So that's how you can distinguish. It's a size 4. The sucker fish, but those are still annoying, so you may come across them, and they're not worth very much. But for the most part, if you can tell the difference in terms of size, then it's a lot easier. So just because there's a fin doesn't mean it's a shark. Now, the hammerhead shark sells for 8,000 bells. It's also an ocean fish. It's 6 with a fin, size 6 with a fin, 4 p.m. through 9 a.m. And then the great white shark, also 4 p.m. through 9 a.m., also an ocean fish, also size 6 with a fin, and it sells for 15,000 bells. So that's the most expensive one, the great white shark. So the whale shark is a 13,000 bell fish. It can be caught in the ocean. It's a size 6 with a fin, and it can be found all day. So it's not as expensive as the great white, but it's still an expensive fish, more expensive than hammerhead. So that's the second most expensive in terms of sharks. But there is still the barrel eye, which is a fish that's actually all year round, and the coelacanth as well, all year round. The difference between these is they are 15K ocean fish, but they're dependent on a couple things. So the barrel eye is a size 2 fish. So it's very hard to find because there's a lot of size 2 fish and they're not worth very much. So that's very difficult to catch, low rate of trying to find that. But the coelacanth is dependent, it's a size 6 and it's dependent on rain. It needs to be raining in your island for you to catch one of those. So yeah, those are basically the prices and the fish you can catch in June. Now, I would recommend to go catch in the ocean. It is more profitable to catch in the ocean versus the river, unless you are in the time period from 6 a.m. through